What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Hopefully you guys are all doing great. Today we're going to be looking at a very awesome figure right now. It's the Dragon Star series Jiren. Personally, ever since I've seen dope characters in Dragon Ball Z, I just obviously want the figures, and Jiren was pretty high on that list, and I'm really happy to have him right now. I know SHF is going to take quite a while to make one, considering the fact they've just made Goku Black. This will do. This is awesome. For $20, I mean, this line is really cool because it's giving you characters that are not out yet in SHF, considering that Kaba, Kale, being the Build-A-Figure, and then, now here, Jiren. So we're going to take a look at Jiren real quick. I'm using my boxes. Don't mind my computer in the back. I'm using the boxes as a little diorama, which I'm going to get a new one very soon. But yeah, guys, let's take a look at this figure and then show some size comparisons and then see if you guys want to pick it up. So yeah, these are the Dragon Stars. We actually found these at Walgreens. They're $20, $19.99 plus tax. Not anything crazy, but the packaging is pretty dope. Some pretty dope Jiren artwork, Dragon Ball Super logo. And then the back of the box. So this is the wave out right now. This is the first wave that it's going to hit stores, and then this one's going to be next. So right now we're getting Blue Vegito, Kaba, and Jiren right here. We have all three, so we're going to be taking a look at all three in future videos. But for now, it's just Jiren. And then the Build-A-Figure, awesome. Kale, I cannot wait for that one. Put it in the display. That's so awesome, man. So I'm really happy about this line. And I just wish they would, like, distribute them a little bit better, because I still haven't seen the Goku Black line with Zamasu and all them. I haven't seen them yet. But, yeah, I'm happy I got this one. So that's a quick look at the box. Not much at the bottom, like I said. So, yeah, let's take a look at this. Okay, so first taking a look at the aesthetics and everything, as you can clearly tell, he represents Jiren pretty awesome, because you know Jiren's like has kind of like skinny legs and he's like super like built. So for a $20 figure, they did a pretty good job. The articulation is not bad. The paint is very simple, so it's like pretty much clean. It's not really any splotchy paint anywhere. And yeah, you do get these like kind of weird articulation, like it shows the little points of articulation, but it doesn't really bother me that much. So yeah, taking a look at the head sculpt, man, I think it's all right for a $20 figure. It's not super perfect. I wish they would have maybe done like the little pupils, like how it is on the box and everything. But I mean, the head sculpt does look pretty good. You can see the gray underlining under the eyes. And as you can see, you kind of know what I'm talking about with the pupil. But that's just the lighting. So I mean, I guess you can mess with it a little bit and make it look like a little bit more accurate. But yeah, taking a look at this, and then you got the size, you got his ears and everything. Very simple. It's kind of like a white, gray paint. Yeah, taking a look at everything else, the paint is pretty good. The gloves and everything is pretty accurate, I guess, to the anime. Maybe my only minor complaint would be maybe that the legs are kind of small. Not that it's not accurate, but it kind of makes it hard to stand a little bit at times, but it seems to be doing pretty good on camera for you guys. If you look up around that much, not really any movement there. And then looking down, it's pretty good. It's like, whatever, so we can look down on his opponents. Now his arms do come up a good amount. So you do get a swivel at the shoulder right here at this point, and then you get another rotation at the arm. Then you got a very nice double jointed elbow right there. You got a swivel at the wrist right here, and then there's a hinge right there too. So yeah, the arm articulation is pretty good. A lot of people have been asking me if you could do like kind of like the cross arms. And you know how SH Figure Arts sometimes puts in cross arms like accessories, but it's kind of hard to do it on this figure. Even though the articulation is pretty good, it's just his body's really bulked up, so it's kind of hard to do the cross arms. I mean, you could maybe kind of finesse it a little bit. Let me try. I don't know. Maybe some people will be more successful than me, but yeah, I tried to do it before and kind of wasn't working out. But for the ab rotation, it is 360 degrees, so that's pretty good. But there is no ab crunch, so that kind of sucks. I think that's a common theme in this line, that there is no ab crunch. But it's okay, it doesn't really bother me that much. I've been having him vanilla posed on my shelf for like a while now, so I mean, he still looks awesome. And the paint, as you can see, the paint is still pretty clean throughout. It's not really anything splashy, or maybe the plastic was already cast in this paint. I'm not too sure. But yeah, taking a look at the legs, they're kind of weird a little bit. As you can see, like, if you move this leg, then both of the legs move. I don't know. Yeah, you can tell right there, but you do get a swivel right here. You got a double jointed knee that goes like 90. You got rotation. You do not get rotation at the boot right here, but you do get this rotation here. It does go side to side, and then you got up and down. And you got ankle pivot, so that's pretty good, so you can stand up better. So your articulation is pretty good on this guy, I'm not gonna lie. So there's a quick look at his articulation. He does come with some accessories, so let me show those off real quick. Yeah, so right here, as you can tell, out of the box, he comes with the fist and hands. And he comes with a pair of like blast hands, key hands. Yeah, these are the only hands he's gonna come with. You got the open hands, and then you got the fist hands. And here's the head to Kale, which looks pretty awesome. The hair looks nice. It's like a Broly type color, you know, it's like that weird green yellow color. It looks cool. The head sculpt looks pretty good. So has that weird little mark right there at the chin, but other than that, the eyes are whited out, and you can tell the earrings look good. So yeah, that's the look at the head. So here he is compared to the Resurrection of SHF Goku. As you can tell, the size difference pretty good. I mean, Jiren's a little taller than Goku, so this looks good in my book, so I'm really happy about this one. And here he is compared to Frieza. See, Frieza is very small, so yeah. Here's a bigger character to compare him to. Here he is next to the SHF Nappa. Yeah, there's a better look. As you can see, Nappa's a little bit bigger, a little wider, so yeah. Jiren looks good on my scale. I mean, it's not gonna be perfect, but not even SHF scales with itself perfect, so. Here's a little look next to Beerus, the God of Destruction. So yeah, hopefully you guys got the idea of how tall he is. Let me compare him to a Marvel Legend real fast, just in case. Here is the Marvel Legends Ant-Man. So you guys can get an idea of how he looks, or how tall he is. Yeah, thank you very much, Ant-Man. So yeah, guys, that was a quick little insight of the Jiren figure. Really stoked about this, so I'm really happy I have them in my collection now. Go out and hunt for them at Walgreens right now. We're hitting California. I'm not sure if they're hitting anywhere else yet, but hopefully you enjoyed this little quick review, and I'll catch you guys next time. Make sure you're subscribed and follow me on my social medias if you want, and I'll catch you guys next time. Later, guys.